इन फ्लैंडर्स फील्ड्स बाय जॉन मैक्रे। जॉन अलेक्जेंडर मैक्रे वॉज अ कनाडियन पोएट, फिजिशियन, ऑथर, आर्टिस्ट एंड सोल्जियर ड्यूरिंग द फर्स्ट वर्ल्ड वॉर। ही इज बेस्ट रिमेम्बर्ड फॉर दिस पोएम विच इज कंसिडर्ड द मोस्ट पॉपुलर पोएम रिटन ड्यूरिंग द वॉर। फ्लैंडर्स फील्ड्स इज अ कॉमन नेम फॉर द वास्ट ग्रासी एरियाज इन बेल्जियम वेयर थाउजेंड्स ऑफ यंग मैन डाइड ड्यूरिंग द फर्स्ट वर्ल्ड वॉर। रेड पॉपीज ग्रू इन द फील्ड्स ओवर द ग्रेव्स ऑफ द फॉलन सोल्जियर्स। इट इज थॉट दैट कैनेडियन सोल्जियर डॉक्टर जॉन मैक्रे बिगेन राइटिंग दिस पोएम ऑन द इवनिंग ऑफ 2 May 1915 इंस्पायर्ड बाय डेथ ऑफ हिज फ्रेंड Alexis Helmer. Macrae's poem led to the poppy becoming one of the world's most recognized symbols for soldiers who have died in conflict. In Flanders fields, the poppies blow between the crosses, row on row, that mark our place, and in the sky the larks, still bravely singing, fly, scarce heard amid the guns below. The explanation. In Flanders Fields begins by immediately placing the reader in the fields of Flanders along with the narrator. The speaker, more than likely Maker himself, describes the field around him and how it is marked with row on row of crosses. Amongst the crosses are other rows of poppies blowing the wind. The crosses represent the dead at Flanders, a battlefield in Belgium during World War I. Whether each cross does indeed mark a grave is not made clear. Bodies were most likely lost in the chaos, and the crosses have been erected as a memorial. Additionally, as an ode to the fallen, the earth has sprouted rows of bright red poppies. The poppy has now come to stand as the flower of Remembrance Day in Canada and Europe. And it too marks where soldiers once stood who are now lost or buried. Both the crosses and the poppies are marking this spot so that no one could possibly forget what happened. Stanza 2. We are the dead, short days ago. We lived, felt dawn, saw sunset glow, loved and were loved, and now we lie in Flanders fields. In the second stanza, the narrator is speaking for those that have been lost, as well as those that survived and have been changed by the war. He states that we are the dead, and that only a few days ago they were alive and moving around Flanders fields. The speaker is seeking to remind the reader in this stanza that these were real men, they really did exist and are not just a metaphor or distant tragic loss. He says that we lived, felt dawn, saw sunset glow. They felt and lived just like everyone else. Additionally, they loved and were loved. The narrator is hoping to help the reader empathize with these men by making them into real people. Stanza 3. Take up our quarrel with the foe. To you from failing hands we throw the torch, be yours to hold it high. If ye break faith with us who die, we shall not sleep though poppies grow in Flanders fields. So this third stanza, which is the concluding stanza, is a call to arms. Though these men have passed and many others have died as well, the speaker is calling on the reader to take up our quarrel with the foe. He is hoping to inspire those reading this poem to take up arms and stand up against the enemy. He continues saying that from their hands they throw the torch. Although their hands have failed, there is still a chance for success in the reader accepts the challenge and uses their hands to hold high. The last lines of the poem are haunting. They speak to the fact that if the reader of this poem do not do as they have been asked, if they do not pick up where the dead have left it off, the dead shall never sleep. They will be haunted by their failure and in turn, metaphorically, haunt the living. The final lines use the image of the poppy once more. Though the field in which they lie is filled with poppies, the blessing and adorning the land, still they shall not sleep if they are denied a future success.